everyone. It's me, Carmela, from Happy Calories Don't Count. And, you know, life can be challenging. And so we look to little nuggets of wisdom or inspirational books or friends to help us through challenging times. And oftentimes there's just one little piece of sage advice that will get you through a situation or something that just sticks with you that you come back to over and over and over again. And one of my favorite little life lessons, if you will, was given to me by my calculus professor in college, Dr. Vander Beek. And so in case you haven't already figured this out yet, I'm a little bit of a type A personality, and I was a very high-strung college student, you know, always studying, always freaking out about the next test and all of that stuff. And I was in Dr. Vander Beek's office a lot during office hours to make sure that I wasn't making any mistakes. And, you know, they could, because, you know, you only got the answers to the odd numbers in the back of the book, and I needed to make sure that I got all of the answers right. And so one day he was trying to teach me this problem-solving skill, and he was going to use the metaphor of how to make a cup of tea to do so. So I'm going to share that with you today. So how do you make a cup of tea? Well, silly me, I said, well, you get some boiling water and you get a tea bag and you put the tea bag in your cup and you add the boiling water. You wait a few minutes and you got some tea, right? No. That was not specific enough. I needed to step by step tell him how to make a cup of tea. And we went round and round a couple of times because I still was not getting specific enough. And it finally got that it was so specific that I had to walk into the kitchen. And then I had to walk over to the stove and I needed to get the tea kettle and I needed to take the tea kettle over to the sink. And then I needed to take the lid off the tea kettle. And then I needed to turn the faucet on and put the tea kettle under the faucet. You get the idea how step by step meticulous this whole process was. And I don't want to bore you with the details. So suffice it to say that it was very slow, very tedious, every single step in how to make a cup of tea. And then, ta-da, I had successfully made a cup of tea because I had illustrated every single step in the process, and therefore I knew how to make a cup of tea. Then he says, okay, Carmela, you want to make some tea, but the tea kettle's already full of water. What do you do? And so, silly me, I say, well, you just turn the stove on so that, you know, your water will start getting hot, and then you get your mug and you just make your tea. No. And this is where he was brilliant, and I have used this metaphor to solve so many problems in my life. You take the tea kettle and you take it back to the sink and you pour out the water. You put the tea kettle back on the stove and you start over. Why would anyone do that? Because you know how to make the tea already. You've just told me, or I had just told him, I'm using this as a metaphor with you. So I just told him how to make a cup of tea. So I knew how to make a cup of tea. And now I'm encountering a set of circumstances that are different. And rather than taking a shortcut where I think I might know the answer, but particularly in terms of a complex story problem in calculus, oftentimes they'll give you bits of information that are not relevant to the calculations you need to solve the problem. And that is also true of life. In life, you will encounter situations where you have more information than you need to solve the problem in one area, but you don't really have all the information that you need, and you won't be able to figure that out unless you throw out the tea water and start over from the beginning like you know how to do. So this is a gem that I have used over and over and over to help me navigate some of my bigger challenges in life. And I wanted to share it with you today with special thanks to Dr. Vander Beek, because it really has helped me. And life, you know, it happens, and it happens to us. And this channel, Happy Calories Don't Count, is creating a body and a life we love. And our body comes naturally from connecting with it and partnering with it. And unfortunately, there are times during life that become very challenging, and that sometimes we can use the emotions and the upsets of life to interfere with the relationship between us and our bodies. And so I'm hoping twofold: to give you a tool, making tea, to learn to look at life a little differently, look at some of these challenges you may be encountering a little differently, but then also to know, always go back to the beginning. And the beginning, as far as Happy Calories Don't Count goes, is reject the diet and exercise model and connect with your body. Reject the model, connect with your body. I'll say it again. Reject the model, connect with your body. Your body has all the answers. You follow the wisdom and guidance of your body, and you will soon be creating a body and a life you love. I thank you for your time. I hope this video was helpful, and I will see you in the next video. Thanks so much. Bye.